In one of my previous videos, we went around this house and took a number of readings, and we recorded them onto a rise and fall level book. Now, what I wanted to do in this video was show you the other method, which is referred to as height of collimation. So here is a height of collimation level book, and the process of filling out the readings is exactly the same as it was for rise and fall. The only thing that changes on this sheet is instead of having a rise and a fall column down here, we just have the height of collimation column. So, process for height of collimation as far as filling it out, it's exactly the same as the rise and fall level book. It's only when we start calculating it that it becomes different. So, in order to work out our RLs, we knew that our datum had an RL of 10 meters. So what we need to do is work out what the height of collimation is for the datum. And all we do is we add our first reading, our backsight, to our known RL to give us the height of collimation for this set of readings. So height of collimation, it's just like saying what height the actual instrument is. So, if we take 10 meters as the height of our datum, plus our 2.395, add that together, we get a height of collimation of 12.395. So, for the rest of the process, all we have to do is take the figure that's in this column away from 12.395, and that will give us our RL. So 12.395 minus 2.050 is going to give us 10.345. Now, unlike the rise and fall sheet, we don't use the consecutive numbers. We now go back to here. 12.395 minus 1.970 will give us 10. 0.425. So then 12.395 minus 1.888 will give us 10.507. 12.395 minus 1.808 will give us 10.587. 12.395 minus 1.722 will give us 10.6. Oops, sorry, 673. Okay, 12.395 minus 1.664 gives us 10.731. Twelve point 395 minus 1.609 will give us 10.786, and 12.395 minus 1.534 will give us 10.861. Now, we get down to here. We keep going. So 12.395 minus 1.493 will give us 10.902. Okay, so we're down to our first lot of readings. So now the changeover. So what we do, we know that height. Sorry, we need only to work out the height of collimation for this side. So we take our known height here and add our backsight. So 10.902 plus 1.732 will give us a height of collimation of 12.634. And we then start the process again. So 12.634 minus 1.795 will give us 10.839. 12.634 minus 1.859 will give us 10.775, and we keep going down. It's going to be 10.698. This one will be 10.622. This one will be 10.582. 10.501. 10.418. 10.345, and of course 12.634 minus 2.634 is going to give us 10. Oh, wrong zeros. Okay, so again we can do a couple of checks. If we add up our back sights, add up our fore sights, and work out the difference, then in this case, of course, it's a closed survey. The difference should be zero. And same here, we can add up our, or we'll take our first RL away from our last RL. And again, because this is a closed survey, our answer should be zero. And if you've done an open survey, so you haven't finished at the same point you started, then the difference between this first check and the second check, it should be the same. And just in case you don't believe me, here is the rise and fall level book, and you would notice that these figures, or the RLs for each point, are exactly the same. So have a look at the one there, right in the middle at the change point, 10.902. And we go back to our height of collimation, and there at the change point, 10.902. So there you go, there's another method of calculating the RLs for the points that you've taken. Instead of using rise and fall, you can always use the height of collimation method.